welcome Tahira, please.
Please subscribe to our channel, and for latest updates, don't forget to press the bell button.
Wonderful. Ileana, if I could request you to please sashay on. She's going to join. First, they need you. Once they're satisfied with having you here, then the designer. Mrunali, if you can join us. And Athiya. If I can now request all the designers and all the okay, now all of you guys need to stay here because you must stay here. We're going to begin by talking to all of you designers about the, I mean, this collection is breathtaking. Each one of these ladies looks so stunning, I have no words. So I'm going to let you speak and tell me about your collection and about the outfits your showstoppers and your model are wearing, okay? Mrunalini, we'll start with you.
Hello. Yeah. Hi, I'm Mrunalini Rao, and I have showcased a collection inspired from a lotus flower, and it's called Utpala, and this is my debut collection at Lakme Fashion Week, and I'm really happy for the way it has come out, and these two gorgeous ladies rocked it today.
Your collection is inspired by
from a lotus flower, and Utpala is a Sanskrit word for it.
Yes, and if you can talk to us about the designs they're wearing.
So Athiya is wearing Athiya is wearing a gode skirt in off-white with a yellow godes in it, and a pink blouse with a nice lotus printed organza dupatta. And Ileana is wearing a purple skirt. I had reinterpreted the lotus flower in its abstract forms, and she's wearing a fully embroidered bridal lehenga with a little hint of pink and a yellow, and she looks gorgeous.
She does.
I'll pass her on the phone.
Athiya and Ileana, we'd like to talk to both of you. Tell us about the outfits you're wearing and how you feel, because you all look stunning walking down the ramp. So I want to know how you felt.
I always love walking the ramp. I feel like backstage, there's so many nerves and excitement, and you see all the beautiful clothes everybody's wearing. This one was extra special because I was walking with Ileana. And I think this collection is beautiful. I loved how it started with lighter colors, and then towards the end, it got deeper and more beautiful. I felt really pretty and elegant.
It was nerve-wracking, as always. I always feel whenever I'm doing a ramp walk, it's just a little out of my element. But I had massive amount of fun doing this one. Again, it was super special because of you. I got to see this one after years, it feels like. It's been years. But I think it's even more special because this was your debut show. And thank you for trusting us. Thank you for letting me bring my own quirk. Mrunalini was really cool. She let me wear boots with it. So I was like, I got to wear boots with my lehenga. So I think her collection was gorgeous. I love the colors you've used. And I love that you've kind of let me do my own spin on this and make it a little badass. So thank you.
I did not know you were wearing boots under that.
Yes, ma'am.
You can't even tell. There you go. Wonderful. Pooja, if we can hear from you about your collection, it's inspired by the cherry blossom.
Yes, it is. And as we all know, that cherry blossoms are very significant towards Japan, India, and various other parts of the world. As you can see, I'm also wearing a very Indo-Jap look today, inspired by the same. Also, my collection name is Sar, and it basically means crux of the last 10 years. We complete 10 years this year. So you would have seen the best silhouettes that we've had in the past decade on the ramp today.
This is a very interesting take on the cherry blossom, especially with the colors. So yes. Do you want to talk to us about the color palette that you've used?
So for me, cherry blossoms is all white and shades of ivory and a little tinge of pink, which you obviously saw on the ramp today. And Tahira has been my muse for a very long time now. And I'm so glad I could debut on the runway with her in this beautiful outfit, which has absolutely no embroidery at all. But as you can see, we've handcrafted loops. So a little inspiration from origami, which again is very Japanese. And even the blouse per se is all about emphasis on the cut. So yeah.
Thank you, Tahira. You're the muse. We'd like to hear from you.
I'm a newbie out here. They all are professionals and been here and done that. I was telling Atiya, I think I ran like a horse on the runway today. But this is the second time that I'm coming. The last year was also special. Last year I was a reflector because I was bouncing off light off my bald head. Today I was a horse. But I'm so, but I'm so glad that Pooja trusted me with this. And I sort of resonate with what she's made me wear because it's simple yet doesn't have much embroidery or work and still it has something to say. So I feel that's me. And I love what I'm wearing. I'm feeling very pretty and beautiful, courtesy her.
And Sunaina, your collection is inspired. It's dedicated to your best friend.
So it's called Promises. I always associate this word with weddings, and my best friend wrote a letter to me asking me to make her wedding outfit, and that's how this collection started. So it builds to her wedding outfit, which was the finale look. I wish you all could see it, but that model was busy. She had to work for another show. So I've tried to show you guys the vision of my bride, basically.
And talk to us about this outfit. This outfit is so pretty, it doesn't need any jewelry at all.
So this is a sequin sari, and as you can see, there's a lot of ombre going on. The size of the sequin also increases as it goes to the pallu. And just to add a little bit more drama, we've added sequin, like a sequin-filled cape attached to the blouse, because I've been told you can never have too much bling, so.
I yeah. agree with you there. This one is bling all along.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. I think I'm going to break for quick questions from the media. Then we'll do a quick partner.